So, Brentford Football Club, or Soccer Club if you live in the US, they got promoted to the English Premier League for the first time in 74 years. And their stories are one of the stories people like to hear. You know, the underdogs who overcame the odds to reach the top. But in 2021, other clubs also got promoted, whether it's in England, Italy, Spain, Germany, and other countries. So what makes Brentford's promotion special? Well, it's the way they achieved it. They used data, a lot of data. So, to fully understand their story, we have to understand the story of their owner, Matthew Benham.
Benham, who is an Oxford physics graduate, is not only a lifelong fan of Brentford, but also the founder of Smart Odds, which provides statistics, analysis, and predictions on a range of different sports for professional gamblers and clients.
So, when he bought the club in 2012, he knew that he couldn't compete with the big budget clubs, because the gap was simply too big. He decided that the only way to bridge that gap is to use what he liked the most, analytics.
His idea was to use numbers and statistics to identify undervalued players, develop them into bright prospects, and then sell them and make a big profit. The data used would include metrics like expected goals, expected assists, and key passes. Using this approach, they would simply buy players that fit their style, but at a lower price.
And guess what? It worked like a charm.
Benham used FC Midtjylland, a Danish football club he owned, as a pivot for his data experiments. And then he implemented what worked at Brentford.
And this is the result. Using this approach, not only did they maintain a profitable business, but the team kept on improving and improving, and next year they're gonna clash with the big boys in the Premier League. But the main question is, for how long can they maintain this? Because more and more clubs are starting to use data analytics in their player transfer strategy, which means more clubs will start to compete on buying these undervalued players, hence their price won't be that low anymore. So these small teams will have to find new innovative ways to bridge that gap with the big clubs. And honestly, as a football fan, I simply cannot wait to see what tricks these underdogs have up their sleeves.